So the Executive Council meeting was presented with this agenda number 3, which was about the total dissolution in effect of GSCASH and replacement by the UGC regulation. 2 or 3 deans were allowed to put their opinion, but in fact, when members, the elected representatives of the teachers, tried to speak, they were actually sharply censured, and the agenda was passed without any discussion.
The last time there was a similar attack on the GSCASH, not to the same extent, but last time when it happened, it was in 2002-03. There was a sexual harassment case against a faculty member, and that was the first time that a faculty member was actually punished. The administration set up a committee to relook at the GSCASH rules and procedures and tried to dilute to a large extent its independent nature. Thankfully, it didn't go through.
सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट बात यह है कि GSCASH हमें एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ने या सरकार ने दिया नहीं है। ये इस देश के अंदर जो वुमेन मूवमेंट है और वो सारे लोग जो जेंडर जस्टिस के सवाल पे लड़ रहे हैं और एक लंबी लड़ाई के बाद मिला। विशाखा जजमेंट जब आया था उसके बाद एक बात कही गई थी कि हर एक इंस्टीट्यूशन में, चाहे वो प्राइवेट हो, गवर्नमेंट हो, वहाँ पर एक इंस्टीट्यूशन होना चाहिए जो सेक्शुअल वायलेंस के खिलाफ काम करे और जिसमें किसी भी इंस्टीट्यूशन के हर एक बॉडी का रिप्रेजेंटेशन हो, ताकि किसी भी तरह का पावर एक्सरसाइज करके सेक्सुअल वायलेंस को जस्टिफाई नहीं किया जाए।
There might be somebody close to the administration who's involved in a case of sexual harassment, because why this sudden need to change the very body which has upheld gender sensitization?
One very significant issue is this, that in the Executive Council there is a person called Bidyut Chakravarti, and he was implicated in a sexual harassment case in DU. Okay, and he was found guilty. Actions were taken against him that you cannot hold any administrative position. Okay. That person is sitting in a body and deciding whether GSCASH should exist or not.
You cannot prevent or deter sexual harassment if the people who are in charge of inquiries are completely subject to pressure from senior levels.
During our time also, there was a right-wing government, and it's a similar government today, but I think the nature of the government itself is very different. The entire attack ever since this person has taken over has been on the student, has been on the teachers, has been on the institution as such.
आज के तारीख में हम देखें कि JNU के संबंध में जिस NGO को दिया गया है वो BJP की एक लीडर की वाइफ चलाती है। जाहिर सी बात है कि BJP का जेंडर के सवाल पे क्या पोजीशन रहा है ये मुझे बताने की जरूरत नहीं है। Everybody knows very well.
JNU is safe and secure for a large number of people in this campus is particularly because of this GSCASH. Because there was a supportive mechanism in which the students and the teachers and staffs could go and file a complaint without having that fear that, you know, the information, the confidentiality will be leaked and the breach of trust was not there. But in ICC, since it is a nominated body, that sort of confidence is not there.
I think it's a political attack from the government also, that they want to sabotage such kind of democratic bodies in this country. Ki koi soch hi nahi paaye ki is tarah ka body bhi kisi institution mein exist kar sakta hai, jahan par koi bhi mahila जा करके फ्री होकर के, माने वो सिर्फ टीचर स्टूडेंट ही नहीं, कैंपस के कोई कॉन्ट्रेक्चुअल वर्कर तक जा करके फ्री होकर के कंप्लेन दर्ज कर सके कि भाई मुझे इसलिए निकाला जा रहा है बिकॉज आई स्पोक।
GSCASH said that, you know, because the confidentiality and so on is concerned, without taking the consent of the complainant, we will not be able to hand over the file to ICC. So they have come with a battalion of security guard to seal the office. And after GSCASH also sealed their own documents in place, but GSCASH office was double locked by the administration.
It is also an institution which created atmosphere for gender sensitization, and in fact opened up way many debates than you would find in a normal campus. People who are now going to run the ICC, from what I am told, have no experience in dealing with sexual harassment, so obviously they have no idea what they are doing. Plus, if they just act on at the behest of the vice chancellor or the administration in general, then obviously there is no justice expected from them.
For us, the grief is, you know, there is an institution which we will fight for, but that institution exists for justice, and justice is now denied in JNU.
as a political statement, today when they are rejecting the existence of the GSCASH body, we are going ahead with our election. We are going to conduct our GSCASH election. We want to give that message loud and clear that you might not recognize GSCASH as a body, but for us, the Gender Sensitization Committee Against Sexual Harassment still exists, and we will send our representative.